strange. There are still signs of the World Serpent all over the lake. But we saw him disappear at Ragnarok.
That could only mean the legend was true all along. That blow from Thor sent Jormungandr straight back in time. A younger Jormi, fresh from Jotunheim, would grow into the serpent we know.
When we first met the snake, you said that he found Atreus familiar. Perhaps they met in Jotunheim.
Perhaps so, brother. We'll have to ask the lad for that story when we next see him.
When Jormungandr attacked Thor in Asgard, it seemed personal somehow. But there's no way they could have met before that, is there?
I've been pondering that, and I have a theory. We know the lad spent his time in Jotunheim learning soul magic. Perhaps the serpent figured in.
You mean Atreus placed some other giant soul into him? Someone who already hated Thor to begin with?
Exactly! Though that doesn't narrow it down much, I grant you. I wonder if Jormi even remembers, after all this time, who he once was.
Your master is no more! Be at the
knee! I'm not at the knee!
Careful, brother! You're covered in Bifrost!
More of these Asgard fragments out there, the Einherjar will continue to be a nuisance for the realms.
Only if we do nothing. The realms will never heal if they remain.
How many more?
Only one way to find out.
Freya, something is on your mind. What is it?
Freyr's sword. I'm glad he got it back.
Odin stole it?
Not quite. It couldn't be stolen. It had to be given freely. Freyr had it forged in his younger days, imbued with its own motives and passion. For centuries, he swore he would only ever set it down in death or upon meeting the love of his life. Both he and the sword were romantics, you see.
Careful, brother. You're covered in Bifrost.
Since Odin is dead?
They are soldiers. They will always be loyal to him, alive or dead. It is a matter of honor.
Yes, they will continue to follow his orders and keep the realms under his thumb.
Not for long, they won't. Don't know if you've heard, but we're gonna say goodbye to Brock in Svartalfheim.
A funeral?
Yeah. We're meeting at Rab's Tavern in Nidavellir.
We will be there.
Ragnarok armor's on the house. We'll call it a commemorative piece. Impressive. Y'all feeling, cracky? Go show it all.
It fits.
Woohoo! Looking good! Now go show it all. Better get that armor nice and bloody. Go show it off.
It fits.
Y'all feeling, crafty? And what about Freya? What can I do for you? Talk for a spell?
Freya, when Hildisvini went to Helheim, how did he not freeze to death?
A perk of the Jofur.
The boar-shifting warriors of Vanaheim. As wise in statecraft as they are deadly on the battlefield.
So they may shift into whatever form they like.
Sure. So long as the only two shapes they'd like to shift into are human and boar.
Mimir, there's something I wanted to ask you about. Kildasvini told me about your visit to secure Hell's army. But was reluctant to elaborate when it came to negotiating with Krasfelger.
Ah, yes. Well, I can see why he'd hold off on such a subject until he saw if we survived the battle.
Mimir. What exactly did you promise the large bird?
Oh, nothing too horrifying.
Enough talk for now. Be ready.
Thanks for grabbing that for us.
Profane alternate lyrics to my ballad. Absolutely disgusting. But now I wish I could remember some of them.
The paperwork that man created for me. I had to build a chest just for his violations. A big one.
I taught him 20 different ways to cold forge a bolster. Once. He taught me a slightly easier method of wire pulling, and from that day on, called me his apprentice.
A true asshole he was. Gods, I'm gonna miss him.
Hi. Y'all made it. Just about to send him off.
I have met many on my travels. You are one of the few I would call friend.
I always thought you were one of the dumbest creatures I'd ever met. Didn't expect you to be the bravest, too.
This world is a darker place for your leaving it.
We're taking him to the Sverd Sands. It's, in the wetlands near the ferry. We'll wait for you there.
is wrong.
I should have changed. Sewn some mourning garb. We're not dressed properly.
We're fine. The dwarves don't typically require formal wear at funerals.
Brock certainly would not.
Perhaps.
So, now you've got me thinking of what I might look like with some jewelry around my neck stump. Maybe some gold woven into my beard. That'd be quite fetching, eh?
Thanks for trying.
There they are, brother.
Oh, come on, surely he'll be along. It's his brother.
Let's hope so. Loss can do things to a man. You made it. We can begin.
Sindri. Brock was.
Thank you. gets bigger, the more you take away.
To all things housed in her silence, nature offers a violence. The bear that keeps to his own line, the wolf that seeks always its own. Hardens as the harsher winter holds, the parent forced to eat its young before it grows. Every bird gone unheard, starving where the ground is froze. The winter sunrise, red on white, like blood upon the snow. Silence.
I don't know if there's anything beyond the light. Afterlives after afterlives or what have you. But if there is, well, I imagine he's causing one crazy ruckus there.
I wrote that dirge for him.
What's it called?
Something profane.
He wouldn't have it any other way.
Forgive Sindri. He's just, I mean, you know.